Is your downloads folder a chaotic mess of files? Do you also struggle to find that one document buried under a sea of random downloads? Imagine if there was a way to organize all of these files automatically, effortlessly, and intelligently. Well, you don't have to imagine anymore. Meet the ultimate file manager LlamaFS, powered by LlamA 3 and blazingly fast with Groq API. Let's take a look at a typical downloads folder where we have a bunch of files with improper names and who knows what else. It's a nightmare to navigate. Searching for a specific file in this feels like finding a needle in a haystack. But with LlamaFS, you can transform this chaos into a perfectly organized folder structure. Let me show you how. So we'll just give our file path over here, which is /Anubhav/Shrimal/downloads, and this is the test folder, and we'll just click this wand icon, and this gives us a perfect directory structure. You can see here that it has also renamed the files from file 1 to this thing and also suggested proper directory structures. I can select all of these changes, confirm the selected changes, and we have a perfect directory structure created by LlamaFS. This project was created by Alex, Thomas, and Ajay as part of the LlamA 3 hackathon. I will show you how you can use this in your machine as well. But first, let me show you the cool demo that they had presented in the hackathon.
The problem is a lot of us have desktops and folders on the new side. Like, this huge clutter is using us. What we're going to be doing is using LlamA 3 to actually speed up our desktop by looking at the file content and reading the file. So for example, this one has a bunch of junk files in here. I have a screenshot. I have some LlamA photos. I have a research paper. I have some text files. A lot of other junk. What I'm going to do is give that to LlamaFS and then run the batch processing commands. Llama in the background is scanning each and every single file in this process. It's going to read the context, classify them, rename them, and organize them in a tree structure. Here we go. Awesome. So what we did is we took all the files here. It's organized them into folders. We can look at the individual files that it changed. So for example, this paper, it renamed it from a big number and a big version to actually something that makes sense. Attention LRP method.pdf, which is what the paper was about. It gives us a summary here. It looks good. We can also see that one of my random text documents, which was just random file.txt, shows that it was supposed to be a bank account. Awesome. What I'm going to do is go ahead and just accept all the files. So instead of like having to manually curate these myself, I can just have the AI do it. So I'm going to confirm the changes, look at my directory, and now everything is neatly organized.
So to set up LlamaFS, you can first go to their GitHub repository, and I will leave the link in the description below, and you can run the following command to clone the repository. Once you have cloned the repository, you can follow the instructions mentioned in the README file. Note that you need to have Python 3.10 or higher and pip package installed. You can install Python 3.10 using miniconda, for which I will leave the link for Windows, Mac, and Linux as well. Next, we can go into the folder using llamafs, and then we will install the requirements using pip install requirements.txt. And while these requirements get installed, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you have found this video helpful so far. It really helps out the channel. Now that the dependencies are installed, we'll also require to sign up on Groq, where you can go to console.groq.com and you can sign up for a free account and create an API key. You can mention any name for it and click submit, and you will get an API key which you should copy. Make sure to not share these API secret keys to anybody. I will be also deleting this key once I am done with the demo video. Next, what we'll do is open the code repository that we had cloned in a code editor and open the main.py file and replace this API key with our own API key. Similarly, we'll go to server.py and replace the key with our API key. Once this is done, save both the files and you are good to go. Using Groq API will push all your content and data to online servers. But in case if you don't want to send the files and content to online servers, you can also install OLlama Moondream, which will run in incognito mode offline. Next, you will run the LlamaFS server using the command fastapidevserver.py. I already have this server running, and so I'm not going to run it again. Now to run the desktop application, what we need to do next is to go into the electron-react-app folder inside the LlamaFS library and run npm install to install the dependencies for the desktop application. I already have the dependencies installed, so I'm going to skip this step. And then we can simply run npm start to start the application. Once the application is open, all you need to do is to mention your path of the folder with all the clutter. And I created a second folder with all the junk files in test 2. Once you mention the path of the folder, you click on the wand icon, wait for 15 to 20 seconds, And voila, in just a few simple steps, you have transformed your cluttered download folder into a neatly organized folders by LLAMA FS. If you see through each of these files, you will also see their summaries and the renamed file structures showing the details of each of these files. All the steps that I have shown to set up LlamaFS are also present in the description below along with the links. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like and share it with your friends who want to declutter their files too. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such content on AI and ML and hit that bell icon to never miss an update. I have lots of exciting content coming your way. I will see you in the next video. Until then, this is Anubhav. Bye-bye.